What's the procedure, sir?
So my name is Dr. Ashish Thakur.
Punna?
Nagpur.
Nagpur, sir?
My case is a case of post-infective soft tissue swelling over the lower aspect of lower third junction of left leg. There is no neurovascular deficit.
What do you mean by post-infective?
So it's actually acute osteomyelitis.
Post-infective means that is a different thing at all.
So it's acute osteomyelitis of the lower aspect of lower.
Acute osteomyelitis.
Tell us what are the finding of acute osteomyelitis. What is the common site of acute osteomyelitis?
Metaphysis.
What is the age of acute osteomyelitis?
Sir,
in which age it is more common?
In children.
Kitni umar hai?
26.
So? Not the location and age.
Sir, so he has a history of...
Dwara se bolo, koi baat. Don't give a diagnosis, you just present your case.
Present. Small, little history.
Present it.
Whatever necessary.
Is a 26.
You tell your inspector, prospector, all other
things. He's a 26-year-old male with a history of swelling since 3 to 4 months over the left lower leg or the medial aspect of tibia, which was initially painless, with complaints of pain starting since last 15 days. Patient also gives, since last 1 month, patient also gives a history of trauma, but that is 15 days back. He has a history of similar small trauma 15 years back over the anterior aspect of thigh, for which he had a prevalent discharge and it was healed with a second IND was required at that time. On inspection, should I direct people to the positive side? On inspection, there is a globular swelling over the medial aspect of lower leg with a small punctum mark over the at the center of the swelling. There is no reddening, there are no scars or sinuses around the... on palpation, the temperature of the swelling is increased with a globular fluid-filled swelling. Cross fluctuation test is positive. The swelling is very tender, fixed to adherent to the bone. Overlying skin is free. The size of the swelling is around 3 to 3 centimeters. The movements of
what is the most important thing you have to see there?
Is there any discharge from the swelling?
There is no discharge. Patient gives history 2 days back of a needle being used.
What is the other most important thing you have to look in these cases?
The color and the size.
You have to palpate the bone. Is there any thickening of the bone?
That
is the most important thing.
There is no thickening of the bone.
On the posterior medial aspect
of the tibia, there is slight thickening at the posterior aspect.
Okay, because unless you say
surface
things,
is also irregular over the.
So I need to tell. Positive finding of
the pathology. That is the most important positive finding of tell in this case. How do you feel for the posterior medial aspect?
So medial margin of just the border of the tibia.
Medial surface
is definitely elevated. Yes. Sir, there are no other positive. There is no neurovascular deficit, there is no lymphadenopathy.
So what is your diagnosis?
Still, you put it in acute osteomyelitis. 3 months duration. And it is not.
So the swelling was very has been increasing slowly, and 3-4 days back it was very big swelling which was being aspirated.
And the pain is what they are
now.
The site of the swelling, constitutional symptoms, very small localized bony swelling in the diaphysis. You still say it's acute osteomyelitis.
नहीं है तो ऑस्टियोमाइलाइटिस तो नहीं है ना, फिर और कुछ हो सकता
है?
बोन कैसी होती है?
So the bone is, it's a bony swelling which is taken over the
periosteum. Even skin bone.
Why not chronic osteomyelitis?
Yeah, what?
Yeah. Is the acute would have told chronic osteomyelitis. Then comes later on other part of it.
Diagnosis also, what do you think it is?
There is thickening of bone, is there for the 3 months or last 3 months.
Any other diagnosis?
What type of chronic osteomyelitis? That comes the best.
Suppose you are not able to reach diagnosis, what you will do now?
So I'd like to get the blood investigations done and X-ray.
Okay, what blood investigation?
So CBC, ESR.
CBC mein kya milega? Kya aspect?
So base ESR.
Base ESR se diagnosis banti hai koi?
Nahi sir.
फिर तो क्यों पता करा रहे हो?
सर एक्सरे
एक्सरे कराओ ना
सर आई
What you require now? To make your diagnosis, what you require now?
X-ray.
Sir, right now, X-ray and
the... X-ray. Ask for the X-ray. Yes. X-ray the cover.
X-ray showed osteolytic lesion at the in the medullary cavity of the lower third of tibia with a sclerotic margins. The
osteolytic lesion kya hota hai?
Osteolytic.
Sclerosis is around the
periosteal reaction, a slight periosteal reaction is visible on the lateral aspect of the
okay. And its medullary canal open or closed?
Sir, sclerotic margin should
be closed. Closed or open?
Closed.
तो इन्फेक्शन खत्म हो जाएगा नहीं हो जाएगा?
नहीं होगा
क्या
करोगे?
अब इसमें एक्सरे में देख के बताओ कि तुम्हारे क्रोनिक ऑस्टियोमाइलाइटिस से क्या क्या फीचर दिख रहे हैं तुम्हें 1 2 3 4 करके
So the lesion with the sclerotic margins around with this, with the periosteal reaction. It's a metaphyseal diaphyseal donut lesion.
यार ये तो मेटाफाइज डायफाइजियल कहाँ हो गया, मेटाफिजिक्स तो बहुत ऊपर है यार.
अरे
मिडिल ऑफ द फिबुला के अंदर, टीबिया के अंदर और कौन सी स्वेलिंग हो सकती है इररिस्पेक्टिव ऑफ द एज. Garrison is also a type of osteomyelitis. कहाँ होता है, किस एज में होता है, किस एज में होता है,
फर्स्ट एंड सेकंड एज.
एडिमेंटिनोमा किस एज में होता
है,
किस एज में होता है भैया. एडिमेंटिनोमा टीबिया के अलावा और कहाँ होता है, जॉ में होता है. फिफ्थ एंड सिक्स डिकेड में ज्यादा कॉमन है.
Treatment.
Why is the treatment? The primary first, we'll go into the cavity. If there is a first. Debridement and phosphorylation, फर्क है, एक ही चीज है दोनों.
debridement is only soft tissue and debridement removal. Saucerization will be doing and shingling
out. Will debridement karenge, saucerization karenge?
Sir, saucerization karenge.
But debridement kyon bol rahe? Debridement kya karte hain?
Kya karte hain saucerization mein? What are the steps you do?
So we do shingling of the cortical cortex of the bone.
Shingling where? How you define saucerization?
You open a.
How you define it?
You make a cortical defect in the.
Define.
What is saucerization? What else is it called? Any other name also?
Saucerization is opening, converting closed cavity into open cavity so that easy drainage can happen. This is simply saucerization.
It's in the shape of a saucer. The base is narrow, the
edge is up
flat. Wider than the base. It's called exteriorization also.
Anybody can tell the complication of osteomyelitis? Numerate. Ambul.
Sir, there can be limb-length discrepancies. There could be pathological fracture.
Pallages, okay.
There could be shortening of the limb or the lengthening of
shortening or lengthening, and
there could be malignancy of sinus tract.
क्या क्या कौन सा क्या ट्यूमर होता है
इसका
मसल का और मोस्ट लीथल कॉम्प्लिकेशन
अक्यूट एक्सेलरेशन ऑफ क्रोनिक ऑस्टियोमायलाइटिस
मोस्ट लीथल मेलिग्नेंसी
अमाइलोडोसिस
स्लाइट अमाइलोडोसिस
एंड एडजेसेंट जॉइंट कैन बी इन्वॉल्व
Deformities भी हो सकते हैं. All this. Not only pathological, but the deformities.
What part of the bone is it? Is it a long bone or a?
This
is the tibia. Very good. So it's a long bone. And which part of the long bone is involved? The metaphyseal and epiphyseal region. Essentially, metaphysis. It is metaphysis centered, whatever it is. Do you think it's a neoplastic pathology or an inflammatory pathology? Neoplastic pathology. Why do you say so? Can you describe the upper end? Can you delineate the cortical margin, the periosteum? No, not at all. Or is the cortex absent in only one localized area? Dhyan se dekho. See, on the upper part of the specimen, you can actually trace the cortical outline up to the metaphyseal region. And just above that, you see that large cortical breach where the tumor seems to be extending outside the cortex and elevating the periosteum. See, this is the cortex. You can trace the cortex right up to here. And after that, this area, you don't see any cortex at all. This region. Okay? So what has happened is this tumor or neoplastic pathology which is occupying the metaphyseal region has penetrated the cortex. There is this region of cortical breakdown. The tumor has gone out of the cortex and lifted the periosteum. The outermost layer is the layer of periosteum. This is the periosteum. This white thing that you can see is the periosteum. And this has got lifted. Okay. The next thing would be that this periosteum is also broken down and the tumor extends into the soft tissue, which is a very common complication of osteosarcoma, which this tumor is. So what are the points which go in favor of an osteosarcoma? First is that it is localized in the metaphysis. It is metaphysis centered. Number one. Number two?
Long
bone. Number three? So there is a cortical breakdown and there is probably an extension.
You see the cartilage also growing skeleton.
This is the, yeah, but that is not, epiphyseal cartilage is not yet penetrated, but that is again a very common phenomenon in osteogenic sarcoma. Okay, so the main thing which is there is cortical breakdown, lifting of the periosteum and possible extension into the soft tissue, which indicates that this is a neoplastic pathology and this is an osteogenic sarcoma. It's a malignant neoplastic pathology. Okay, is this clear? What is Codman's triangle? So there could be new bone formation, subperiosteal new bone formation or extension of tissue under the periosteum which lifts the periosteum, and this results in formation of a triangular space, one surface of which is formed by the periosteum, the other surface is formed by the cortex, and in between we have the subperiosteal new bone or the tumor which is extended. Okay. So this is the Codman's triangle. And is this a characteristic finding of osteogenic sarcoma?
No, ma'am. Actually, it can be like any malignancy.
Any malignancy.
Like Ewing's sarcoma, we can find.
Ewing's sarcoma, Codman's triangle is seen. What is the type of periosteal reaction that you see in Ewing's? And what is the type of periosteal reaction that you see in osteosarcoma? So it is a lamellar reaction that we see in Ewing's. And in osteosarcoma, it is a perpendicular, the periosteal reaction is perpendicular to the cortical surface. Okay? And this periosteal reaction which is seen in osteosarcoma as a reaction which is perpendicular to the cortical surface in the directions of the Sharpe's fibers. What are Sharpe's fibers? They are the fibers which help in adherence of the periosteum to the cortex, and they are laid down perpendicular to the cortical surface. Okay? So when we have a periosteal reaction which is seen along the Sharpe's fibers, then we label it sunburst appearance. It's like the sun bursting. So we call it sunburst appearance. And any other name for this kind of periosteal reaction?
Hair on end appearance.
Anything else? Feathery appearance. We also call it feathery appearance. So there are three names for this kind of a periosteal reaction. Feathery appearance, hair on end appearance and sunburst appearance. And Ewing sarcoma, it is a periosteal reaction which is parallel to the cortical surface. It is laid down in layers. Onion peel appearance. Okay? So that is different. I was asking you whether Codman's triangle can be seen in other conditions. Not chronic osteomyelitis. So any condition in which there is new bone formation, yes, that's true. But it is not a very common feature of chronic non-specific osteomyelitis. It is generally seen in acute osteomyelitis when there is a sudden gush of pus between the cortex and the periosteum and the periosteum is lifted. Because in chronic non-specific osteomyelitis, the periosteal reaction becomes lamellated like Ewing's. Okay? Slowly and gradually, layers of periosteal reaction, one on top of the other. It's like Ewing's. It's not like Codman's triangle. Okay? For Codman's triangle to form, there has to be a sudden gush of or sudden appearance of something between the cortical surface and the periosteum, which is generally seen in acute osteomyelitis. If you have a purulent exudate which goes in between the cortical surface and the
periosteum. Again, I think, one thing, can we say the osteomyelitis, acute or the chronic osteomyelitis, either triangle or Codman's triangle will also be used or not?
It should not be used because it is synonymous with osteogenic sarcoma.
Yeah.
So that is what we have been seeing for ages.
Yeah.
But what I am trying to tell you is that it is not a very specific finding.
So
it is a non-specific finding and it can be seen in other conditions. Say for example an AV malformation or vitamin C deficiency, scurvy, where there can be a hemorrhage which lifts the periosteum. Again we can see a radiological picture which is similar to Codman's triangle.
So for basic teachings, don't use Codman's triangle for the osteomyelitis. Basically for the treatment.
Okay. So that's about osteosarcoma. Any other tumor which are seen in the metaphyseal region? What is the X-ray picture of this kind of an osteosarcoma usually like? When you see the X-ray of this patient, what is it likely to look like? So it will be a mixed lesion. It will be a lytic sclerotic lesion. And what if it's a predominantly lytic lesion? Say a young male, 18-year-old male has come to you with a large lytic lesion which is showing permeation. What is the differential diagnosis that you would like to entertain? I said metaphyseal lesion, not epiphyseal. Metaphyseal lesion. Osteosarcoma, yes. With what type of osteosarcoma? If it's a predominantly lytic lesion. Telangiectatic osteosarcoma. That's why I gave you the age and the sex. Young male presenting with a large lytic lesion in the long bone. Metaphyseal is likely to be that. Okay. All right, what is this? Is pe focus kar dijiye.